In today's podcast, I'm going to talk to you all about productivity and morning routines. And then next Friday, we will talk about afternoon and evening routines. And the first half of this podcast is going to be setting up why my morning routine is different than everyone else's. So hopefully you just listened to the podcast right before this that I recorded 2 years ago that talked about my morning and evening routines at that time. In that podcast, I talk about decision fatigue and setting up routines. And when you set up routines, you start to do things on autopilot so you don't have to make any more decisions. So this podcast is going to build on that one. I want to talk about how we as women are constantly trying to seek some kind of a balance. We want to balance our work and our home life. We want to balance how much time we spend with each of our kids. We want to balance all of these things. But there really is no such thing as balance. And actually, balance is boring. Like if everything's done evenly and there's no passion or something that gets more of you, then that's kind of boring. I think that 90% of us, I have not done a poll, but I'm going to say 90% of people on this podcast are not getting up at 5 a.m. to take a cold shower, meditate, and work out. They're just not going to. So my morning routine that I'm going to talk to you about, you should always know who you're listening to when you're listening to their productivity in their morning routine. I have two teenage kids. They are 16 and 17 year old. I work full time, but I work from home. So I have flexibility in when I work and how I work. I am married. I have a dog and my house is 2,400 square feet. So it's the actual average American home that if you, according to statistics, I live in the typical average American home. I live in a suburb. I do not live in a city. My kids attend private school with no busing, so I have to drive them at least 2 hours a day. That is who you're listening to. That's who I am. I'm 45 years old, and I live in Cincinnati, Ohio. The modern woman, her productivity routines are going to cover seven different items. Not everyone will have all seven, but these are the seven items that I'm going to say that most of us are covering. Number one, our household. Everybody lives in some kind of a dwelling. Number two, cleaning. You got to get that house clean somehow. Number four, shopping. Nothing's getting into this house on its own. You're going to have to actually order it, have it shipped, or go pick it up. Number three, some kind of work. And by work, I mean whatever you do for the majority of your day that is your passion. If you have little kids and your home and your passion is raising those kids on your own without daycare, that's your work. If you homeschool, that's your work. If you volunteer full time, you run the PTA, you run the junior league, that's your work. If you work full time outside of the home, that's your work. If you work from home part time or full time like I do or in direct sales, that's your work. So whatever is your bulk of your day, focus and goal orientation, that is your work. Then number five is yourself. Taking care of yourself, and then optional would be six, having a spouse, and seven, having kids. Now, I know there are people that don't have kids and don't have a spouse that listen to this podcast. I personally chose to opt out of number two. I don't do cleaning. I have a housekeeper. So you're probably not going to be doing all of the things on this list, but you're going to be doing a lot of these things. Okay, so if you're keeping track of what we're doing, number one, we've habitualized our regular daily morning getting ready routine. And number two, you've determined your best work times of when you want to do your household tasks and your work and how much time you need to really ease your way into your workday or if you're the kind of person that can just hit that creativity first thing. Now, step three in creating a morning routine is to create a flex day. I know, really weird. You've probably never heard of this before. This is specific for a woman. I don't know if it's necessarily as important for a man, but for a woman, having this flex day is super, super important for me.